Hello student, today I am going to show you another experiment of the organic lab, that is experiment number 3. What is the experiment number 3? Synthesis of benzoic acid using household bleach. So to synthesize benzoic acid or to prepare benzoic acid, what we have to do? First of all, we have to perform a reaction. Okay, so for that reaction some chemicals are needed. All the chemicals are present over here. So we have to perform the reaction above of this hot plate and in this reaction mixture beaker. So what things are required to initiate, to start the experiment, start the reaction? First of all, need 0.72 ml acetophenone. Okay, so here you can find a pipette. This one is this pipette for exclusively acetophenone, and this can measure only 1 ml. So how much is needed? 0.72 ml. Okay, so I am going to take this 0.72 ml acetophenone. So this is the pipette, this one is the pipette pump, and first of all we have to install this one like this way, and if we scroll it up, the solution will automatically goes up. If we scroll it down, the solution will be fall in the respective container. So first I am going to take acetophenone. Okay, so how much we have to take? 0.72 ml. Then after that, what do you have to add? 24 ml household bleach. This household bleach means this one is NaOCl. So this is the bleach, NaOCl, and you can measure this one using this measuring cylinder. Okay, this can measure 25 ml. What is required? How much is required? 24 ml. So we have to take up to this. Yeah. Then after that, we have to add 2 ml 10% NaOH. Okay. So this one we have to add over there. How much? 2 ml. So to take 2 ml, we can find a pipette over here which is labeled as 10% NaOH, and this pipette can measure only 2 ml. Okay, so we have to take up to the zero. So again I am going to use the pipette pump, and Okay. So now all the three reagents we already took inside the reaction mixture container. So now what we have to do? We have to place this reaction mixture container above of the hot plate, and this we have to heat in between 75 degree. That means actually nearly 75 degree temperature required for this reaction. So the temperature is already seted over here in this machine, in this hot plate. So I'm just going to put this one over here, okay. And what we have to do, we have to wait 30 minutes to complete the reaction. Basically this one is a Halofarm reaction, okay. So we are going to wait for 30 minutes. Okay, so reaction is going on over here. In between this, what we have to do? We have to measure 200 milligram sodium sulfite in between this, okay. And that 200 milligram sodium sulfite, once after completion of reaction, we have to add in the reaction mixture. So now I am going to weigh 200 milligram sodium sulfide, okay. So for that a butter paper is required, so I am going to just put the butter paper over here. Now I just calibrate the machine, make it zero. Yeah, now I am going to transfer 200 milligram sodium sulfide. Here is the sodium sulfide. This I am going to transfer over there. So 200 milligram means actually 0.2 grams. Yeah, so 200 milligram yeah, so we measure 200 milligram. Okay, so now 30 minutes over, so we have to remove this one from the hot plate, and the thing which is rotated inside the container, white thing, is the magnetic bar, okay. So actually this I put initially. Now previously measured 200 milligram sodium sulfide we have to add over here. Now what we have to do? We have to wait 10 minutes for cooling to reach the normal temperature. Okay, we have to wait 10 minutes for what? To reach the normal temperature. Okay, so after 10 minutes what we have to do? We have to take a separating funnel like this. This is the separating funnel, okay. So here you have to transfer the reaction mixture after 10 minutes, and After transferring the reaction mixture, we have to add 10 ml diethyl ether into the reaction mixture also. So two things we have to transfer in the reaction mixture. Two things we have to transfer in the separating funnel. One is the reaction mixture and 10 ml diethyl ether. Now our setup is ready. Okay, so 10 minutes completed. Now I am going to transfer the reaction mixture into the separating funnel. Now 10 ml diethyl ether we have to add over here. We can measure diethyl ether using this measuring cylinder. It can measure only 10 ml. This is the 10 ml diethyl ether. So first I pour the diethyl ether in the reaction mixture, then I transfer this thing into the separating funnel. So by this, all the residue things in the reaction mixture washed by the diethyl ether. Now we have to remove this from the ring and we have to put the cap above of this, tight this one, and like this way we have to shake the two layer properly. Now we have to remove the strip slowly and keep this one for a while inside the ring again, so that two layers are separated properly. Now you can see two layers are separated over here. So first layer, above layer, is for diethyl ether, and second one, the below one, is for the water. So lower one is the aqueous layer and above one is the ethereal layer. Okay, now our intention with the aqueous layer, because in this reaction sodium salt of benzoic acid prepared, so that sodium salt is soluble inside the aqueous layer. So our intention with the aqueous layer, so we have to take the aqueous layer from the separating funnel in a particular container which is labeled as the water layer or aqueous layer. Okay, this is the conical flux. Okay, so I am going to transfer the aqueous layer into the conical flux. Okay, so all the aqueous layer, lower layer, we already transferred inside the conical flux. Now, as I told, sodium salt of benzoic acid is present inside the aqueous layer. So what you have to do, we have to add some acid into this to replace the sodium by H+. Okay, so I am going to add one normal H2SO4 drop wise into the aqueous layer. Okay, and this procedure we have to complete keeping this aqueous layer container inside the ice bath. So now I just keep this one inside the ice bath. Now I'm going to add a normal H2SO4. So after adding some drops, what you have to do, you have to stir this one. Now we can put some drops. Yeah. Now we can see the change. We have to check whether pH of the solution is reached below 3 or not. So I am going to check the pH. Below 3 means it is consumed a little bit more. Yeah. See, it is now below 3. So you can see the white thing. These all white things are the benzoic acid. Now what we have to do, we have to filtrate this benzoic acid. Okay, so for that a filter paper is required. So you have to fold the filter paper like this way and fit it into the funnel like this. Now we are going to transfer the aqueous, whole aqueous layer in this funnel. Okay, so let it be filtered, and in between this we are going to take the weight of this peptides. Now we set this one as 0. Now weight of this peptides is what? We have to wash this one with the ice cold water. So this is the benzoic acid gathered in the center of the funnel. So guys,
Student, now you can see all the prepared benzoic acid are gathered at the center of the filter paper of the cone. Okay, so our next work is what? We have to remove this one from the funnel, and then after that we have to dry this one, and then we have to take the weight of this prepared. We have to take the weight of this prepared benzoic acid. Okay, so I'm going to take the weight of this one. So this is the petri dish. Using this one, I'm going to dry this one. Let it be dry for a while, okay, and then after that we are going to measure the weight of that this prepared benzoic acid. Okay, so now you can see it is almost dry. So what we are going to do, we remove this one from the hot plate, and then after that now we are going to transfer all this white substance into the plate. Now again we are going to take the weight of this petri dish from the weighing machine. So what is the weight? 99.509 grams. Okay, so initial weight of the petri dish that we measure, that is what? This one, 99.269. okay, and now what we got, final weight including benzoic acid is 99.507 gram. so weight of the benzoic acid is what? Difference of these two, so weight of the benzoic acid is 0.238 gram. okay, so this much of thing of benzoic acid we got from this preparation. Okay, so that's all, we got the benzoic acid. So that means it's over. Thank you guys.